Here are 10 neat little tricks we just found out. I bet you don't know all of them. Number 1. Animate animations. Animation players have some really nice tracks. One of them is the animation playback track. With that, you can select another animation player and then add their animations. The animation editor will even show you the animation length, which is just a nice touch. This is really helpful to orchestrate a complex animation without having tons and tons of tracks, especially when you want to use the same animation over and over again. We use this for these buttons and texts. They all have a fancy appear animation. In the tutorial, we just call their appear animations. But be aware, when you use an instantiated scene with an animation player, you need to make the children editable.
Number 2. Map with scenes. The individual tiles of a tile map can have a collision, a navigation polygon and occlude light. Apart from looking pretty, that is about all they can do. If you need more, you can transform them into scenes. Just map a placeholder tile, iterate the used cells and get a cell ID. Check if it is a placeholder. Then, instantiate a scene, put it where the cell was and remove the cell. Don't forget to factor in the scale of the tilemap if it is not 1. Now you can just map as you would with a tilemap, but get scenes that can do whatever they want. Like these spikes. They can kill you, because that is what they want.
Number 3. Favorite files. In the file system tab, you can right click and add a file to your favorites. This is great to show the most important files some appreciation for their work. It is also very helpful to find them easily. You can even use it on folders. You can also use it to keep track of a small working set of files and remove the star again when you are done working.
Number 4. The right way to trim. Have you ever found yourself removing a file extension using substring? Please stop, you madman. Use trim suffix instead. It is easier to read and write. You can also use trim prefix for prefixes. In general, go read the documentation of string if you haven't already.
Number 5. Find out if you are in the matrix. You can ask your game if it runs in the editor or in the exported version by using OS has feature standalone. Sometimes file extensions and locations change after exporting. Sometimes you don't want your users to find your developer cheats, so just change your code when exporting. You can add your own feature tags too. There are many other built-in feature tags that can help you identify the environment of your application, such as the operating system.
Number 6. Tween stop all versus remove all. Version 3.4 brought a little bit of a strange change. Tween stop all stops the tween, but does not necessarily remove the tracks anymore. So where you could use stop all in the past, you might need to use remove all now, or both. Because it seems like remove all sometimes has a frame delay or something, just be aware that there is something strange going on. The change introduced some bugs in our game at least.
Number 7. No. You can't call a trick how to burn an orphanage, no. Number 7. How to find unused resources and brutally murder them. You can go to Project, Tools, Orphan Resource Explorer. In this hidden space, you can find each resource that is not explicitly used anywhere else. But be careful, if you load them in programmatically, they will still show up here, so don't go ahead and delete everything here without thinking first. Also, in the File System tab, you can inspect the owners and dependencies of a scene. With right-click, Edit Dependencies and View Owners. This helps when you have a scene that you want to remove but need to clear up all dependencies first.
Number 8. Extreme duck typing. You can ask a node if it has a method or a property. Just use hasMethod to make sure a method exists before calling it. A nice application is a takeDamage method. If you have some kind of AoE effect, just call takeDamage on every node that has a takeDamage method. An alternative is to add a node to a group, damageable or something, and check that instead. Whatever fits your game. Similarly, you can check for properties within.
Number 9. You can create own project settings that are stored in a project file. Just go to Project Settings, decide for a place, decide for a type, and press Add. And there it is! Your very own property. You can add overrides for different exports. To read them in the game, use getSetting with the path of the property. Of course, this also works for the predefined ones. Keep in mind, the path is case sensitive.
Number 10. Animation player has a process mode. There's this field in Playback Options Process Mode. I never really cared about it. By default it is placed in idle, which is usually fine. But we found that a badly timed lag spike can sometimes skip a short animation. When this happens in your project or you animate a physics body, use physics. With manual, the animation is not advanced automatically and you have to call advance yourself. If you have more tricks, write them in the comments. If this video was helpful, give it a like and share it around so YouTube thinks we are good at videos. Also, here are more tricks to watch and here are Godot games.